My dearly beloved Foundationites, the COVID-19 pandemic has wreaked debilitating effects to how we normally live our lives. This unseen enemy has brought huge businesses, academic institutions, and even governments down on their knees. A number of people have lost, gave up, or just chose to postpone reaching their dreams of achieving that sought-after academic degree because of the circumstances we are facing. But because of your resilience, the desire to succeed, and the willingness to hurdle all the challenges, you have been part of one of Foundation University's greatest history as you continue to reach for your dreams through our FUEL program. I am personally and profoundly grateful to all of you who have entrusted your future with us during these trying times. As the head of the University Office of Academic Affairs, I assure every one of you of our resolute mission to continue to provide the most efficient delivery of quality, responsive, and relevant 21st century education for all. In this battle against all challenges these times have to give, allow me to share a few lines from William Ernest Henley's Invictus. Beyond this place of wrath and tears looms but the horror of the shade, and yet the menace of the years finds and shall find me unafraid. It matters not how strait the gate, how charged with punishments the scroll. I am the master of my fate. I am the captain of my soul. God bless everyone, and God bless Foundation University.
True colors, and that's why I love you, so don't be afraid. your true colors shining through. I see your true colors, and that's why I love you. So don't be afraid to let them show your true colors.
Our honorary speaker in this year's academic opening is no stranger to Foundation University. As a matter of fact, he currently sits as one of the university's member of the Board of Trustees and has been highly instrumental in all the successes of the university's endeavor. He is a man of experience and profound expertise and the champion of the environment. As a public servant, he served as the Presidential Advisor for Environmental Protection and a member of the Cabinet of the Cabinet Cluster in the Environment and Climate Change during the regime of the then President Benigno Simeon Aquino III from August 2011 to June 2016. He was also a member of the Philippine delegation with President Benigno Aquino III on his official visit to France and to the Conference of Parties 21 gathering of world leaders in France. He also served as the Chief Operating Officer of the Laguna Lake Development Authority from September 2011 to February of 2017, where he presided over the design-build project of the first ever green climate smart building of the Philippine government. He also served as a member of the House of Representatives representing the 1st District of Bukidnon for three consecutive terms from the year 1998 to 2007, wherein he authored the following breakthrough bills: the 1999 Clean Air Act, the 2001 Ecological Solid Waste Management Act, and the 2004 Clean Water Act, and six other laws on the biodiversity and wildlife conservation, coastal resources, protected areas, and plant variety protection. During the May 2010 national elections, he ran under the Liberal Party for a senatorial seat and finished on the 20th place. He also served as the provincial board member of the province of Bukidnon from 1995 to 1998. Our honorary speaker is also an educator. He served as a professor of development management and leadership in the Asian Institute of Management from 2008 to 2009. He also served as a lecturer and eventually the associate professor in the Political Science, Public Administration, Policy and Governance departments of the Ateneo de Manila University School of Government and the Ateneo de Manila Department of Political Science, and at the De La Salle University Graduate School and at the Xavier University Ateneo de Cagayan Graduate School from the years 1998 to 2008. As an environmental champion, he served as a chairman of the Philippine Center for Environmental Protection and Sustainable Development from 2015 up to the present. He is also the member of the Board of the Directors of PATH Foundation, the Population Health and Environment from 2011 up to the present. And he is also a member of the Board of Trustees of the International Alert London, England, Peace Building and Global Climate Change and Resiliency Initiatives in the years 2011 to 2015. Among his meritorious academic achievements include being the first Filipino chosen as one of the only 16 young emerging leaders selected from around the world as the World Fellow in the Yale University. He was also the participant of the Program on Leaders in Development and Environmental Economics of the John F. Kennedy School of Government of Harvard University. He was also a doctorate scholar in the Institute of Culture and Communication, East-West Center of the University of Hawaii, and was awarded as the Most Distinguished Alumnus in 2006. He obtained his PhD degree in Political Science from the University of Hawaii in Manoa, his Master's of Arts degree in Public Affairs, International Affairs concentration from the Indiana University of Pennsylvania, and his Bachelor of Arts degree, major in Political Science from the University of the Philippines, Diliman. Ladies and gentlemen, it is truly an honor to present to you our honorary academic opening speaker, Dr. Juan Romero Nerius Acosta.
Maayo kayong pagbati. Good morning and good day to all of our community members of the entire Foundation University, especially, of course, the members of the board and Dr. Amira Cinco, Dean Cinco, and all of those who have been the pioneering spirit of Foundation University on its 71st year. I'm very proud to be back again with all of you, although virtually on Zoom today, on this opening of another school year in this new normal for all of us, not just for the Philippines, but for the rest of the world. I begin my intervention with all of you on this new school year, a very different school year indeed, because who would have thought that we would be in a situation where the whole world becomes more virtual, more Zoom-based na ang atong mga meetings, ang atong mga ingon-ining classroom settings, synchronous, more than it is asynchronous, because Foundation University is now going to truly be one of the pioneering drivers of expanded learning. And the pandemic has made us, in fact, not just reboot our economy, reboot our society governance, and it has helped all of us, especially universities like Foundation University, schools and institutions of learning, reimagine a new future. Because that's what we really are facing today. COVID-19, the corona pandemic, this entire world that has been upended because of a crisis that none of us could have ever predicted, not even the experts, lead us back to where we are today on this very threshold, where as a university in the Visayas and one of the leading institutions of learning in the Philippines, we return to what it is that we must together rethink, and what we together must reinitiate and re-innovate. So the Foundation University Enhanced Learning, which is fuel a new future, is also a Foundation University empowered leadership in education. And so we can play with FUEL as well in terms of empowered leadership. Because what we're showing more than any other institution of learning in the Visayas or even in the Philippines, 100% ang atong synchronous nga engagement sa atong mga estudyante o sa atong overall academic community. That's something to be very proud about. And as member of the board, I'm truly very gratified to be a part of something as innovative and as cutting edge as this, even as we see the very difficulties and challenges that the pandemic has posed. You see, the pandemic has been caused by the ecological destruction and the climate change impacts on the planet. That's why the virus has what has been called a zoonotic transmission from wildlife, in this case, bats, making its transference to human beings. Nahimo nga because nadaot na ang biodiversity, ang kinaiyahan, nibalhi na ang mga pathogens, ang mga virus, gikan sa atong mga mananap, wildlife, to humans. That has really been where this pandemic has begun. And we must understand that. So those of us who are in the fields of environment and sciences will understand more the causes, and we will also contribute in research and other initiatives in this regard, understanding the situation of how pandemics actually begin. And then also, we have the very sphere of capacities. The pandemic has made us understand that we are truly in dire need of capacities, meaning not just healthcare and hospitals and healthcare insurance and systems that will address the pressing need for health and public health and epidemiology. And so our science majors and those preparing for the medical field and professions, especially our very strong nursing department, will have to really understand now that our education from Foundation University has to do with the building of the capacities for healthcare and healthcare systems. Then we also have the sphere of costs, the impacts of the coronavirus pandemic on the economy, on jobs, on agriculture and food. And so therefore the fields and departments of Foundation that have to do also with understanding food security, economic growth, businesses and entrepreneurship will also have to be reimagined in a manner that we can respond better and more effectively to such crises like the COVID-19 and the coronavirus. And also, lastly, we look at crisis that in governance, in managing, in responding institutionally, as well as in terms of technology to this virus. And it's not just about quarantining and having lockdowns in our communities and in our cities and towns, but it is also about understanding the very role of governance, the very role of balancing what it is that government can do vis-a-vis all of the civil society sectors, including schools and universities like Foundation University. So if you bring that all together, and we call this the mnemonic of four C's, the crisis has wrought, the virus has given us time to think about all of its causes, all of what we need in terms of capacities, all of the costs and impacts, and also what we need to crisis in terms of crisis management. FUEL, Foundation University's enhanced learning, will really serve to link all of those four components. Because in that respect, we will be able to engage even as we're in our homes and in our more limited spheres of physically of spaces, we will still be able to enhance our innovations, our initiatives towards learning in this new normal. So the challenge for us is not just the enhanced and expanded learning, it is also to empower the leadership spaces and potentials of our students and the entire Foundation University community. Those alumni, those benefactors and partners that we've had over the years here and abroad, because we need to claim spaces of leadership in a time and an age that has really called for the kind of reimagination and the kind of recalibration in this new normal. So I would like to just challenge all of us in closing to look not just at the way we're able to innovate, the way we're able to engage our students and parents in this FUEL setting, but to make us, in fact, take concrete initiatives, even for year targets. So this school year, if I may just humbly propose or suggest, we could begin with such initiatives like making Foundation University truly a leader in learning in the virtual cyber internet sphere more than any other university or institution of learning in the region or in the country. And that the way we do this is to increase also the participation of all of our teachers, all of our entrepreneurs, all of our eco warriors, because we need a greener, still in all, a more driven by eco-friendly entrepreneurial initiatives and more outreach to those communities that need not just health interventions, but learning interventions as well. So this is where we can plant, really, in the name of a pandemic that has upset what we used to think was already just a way of life every day, to really making sure that we can concretely plant, because this is 2020, we can plant 2,000 more trees, we can have 20 new entrepreneurial eco-friendly thrusts in our communities around Dumaguete and Negros province. We can have 200 or 2,000 subsidy educational grants for more students in need. We can have more 20 or more new communities where we can sustain our health and educational outreach in this. These should be the concrete pandemic responses we can have as a FUEL program. So for this year, we can do these initiatives. We can start with the very doables, the tangibles that all of us can actively engage in. I would like to end with a note of optimism, and just like Lake Balintsasayaw at the background, this is truly what we should always have, the sense of hope, the fueling of hope. Because when we extinguish hope, we allow for desperation. But when we fuel optimism and a positive spirit, a spirit of giving, a spirit of grit and determination, a spirit of gratitude for all that we still have and are able to still share as a community with our teachers, our students, our families, and all of those who depend on the Foundation University, we can truly say that this pandemic has not just made us anxious, sometimes even rather despondent, but it has made us even stronger and more hopeful. That's what we need as fuel for our very spirits. Daghan kaayong salamat. Mabuhi ang atong academic programs, and may 2020-2021 school year be a chance for us to have 2020 hindsight, but also the fuel of fire and energy and determination for all of us to prevail in this new normal. Good day sa atong tanan. God bless, and may the force and the spirit truly be with all of us every day. FU71, be the one to make the difference.
Thank you, Mr. Acosta. As the Chancellor of Foundation University, I'd like to greet both new and returning members of the Foundation family. Welcome to the new school year. An old Jewish proverb says, "I ask not for a lighter burden, but for broader shoulders." It is during adversity that ordinary people are molded into great men and women of faith and action. And so, consider yourselves as pioneers, forging a new path that many others will walk down in the future. In God's infinite wisdom, He has chosen a unique beginning for your 2020-2021 school year. And it is through this adversity that God will refine and polish you into becoming the burden lifters of our society. We begin this new school year, as Mr. Acosta puts it, as pioneering drivers for expanded learning. With this in mind, it is my hope and expectation that through FUEL and Foundation University, we'll be prepared and equipped to find solutions, help those who need help, and spread hope in our community. I look forward to seeing you rise to that level, and perhaps even exceeding my expectations. Together, let's celebrate the beginning of this new normal and confidently move forward into the future. Foundation University at 71, be the one.
I was a junior high student. I have heard good feedback about FPA. All my friends said that this school makes your student life more exciting and your learning experiences more meaningful. Even in these trying times, I took the opportunity of enrolling in FPA, and I feel at home and celebrated being with its great, approachable, kind, and friendly teachers and staff. For now, we are enjoying the FUEL program of the school, which seeks to respond to the new teaching and learning environment. We are beyond blessed that it still offers us a quality education we deserve despite this pandemic. This program not only focuses on the content and performance standards we're expected to master and perform, but it also teaches us the values of resiliency and flexibility, and most importantly, the core values that each foundationite should possess: excellence, integrity, commitment, and service. With our teachers' technological and pedagogical knowledge, I know that my learning experiences will be great and meaningful. With its accommodating and caring environment, I know that my stay here will be worthwhile and will give me the best and memorable senior high school years of my life. I am one with the others who pray that this pandemic will end. I can't wait to meet the FPA community and hug my friends. To all gray poppies, together we will make this academic year 2020 to 2021 great. For FPA's education is your future. FU at 71, be the one. Be the one that makes a difference. Be the one that gives inspirations and hopes to others.
Hey guys, my name is Cheryl, and I guess the two things that what I've been doing in high school is reading and then testing myself. Other than that, the reason why I chose Foundation is because of the offers that is only offered in FU and not in other colleges. And I guess for a FUEL program that FU is offering, which is one of the reasons why I like about FU is because they offer this program. But aside from that, it is also because FUEL program, it gives you an outcome of enhancing your time management skills. And just a general message to you guys, if ever you guys are doubting on your dreams, don't give up, because You just have to keep fighting for it until you reach them.
Foundation University administrators, deans, principals, and department heads for academic year 2020 to 2021. Victor Vicente G. Cinco, President. Ebenezer Y. Lim, Chancellor. Jasper Eric C. Catan, Director for Academic Programs, Research and Extension, and Online Distance Learning. Jesus Ramon M. Cuevenco, Dean, College of Law and Jurisprudence. Peter Macabingil, Acting Dean, College of Arts and Sciences. Charlotte V. Carino, Dean, College of Business Administration. R.D. Marie M. De Los Reyes, Dean, College of Hospitality Management and Head for Food Processing Facility. Jobert R. Klein Quercom, Acting Dean, College of Agriculture. Marlon A. Tanilon, Dean, College of Industrial Engineering and Technology. Erlinda N. Kalumpang, Dean, College of Education. John Robert D. Hineral, Dean, College of Nursing. Jeffrey M. Rivera, Officer in Charge, College of Computer Studies. Bimboy C. Cueno, Dean, College of Criminology. Victor Vicente G. Cinco, Chair, Department of Architecture and Fine Arts. Evelyn Joy R. Gallio, Head, Technical Vocational Program. Charisa Lun L. Villanueva, Officer in Charge, Office of Student Life. Margaret Grace I. Martinez, Principal, FPA Grade School. Rika May T. Montesire, Principal, Junior High School. Aljon B. Silorio, Principal, Senior High School. Shane Claire B. Rindora, Dean, Admissions and Records. Glenn May D. Luzares, Director, Quality Assurance Office. Cindy T. Inolpe, Officer in Charge, University Library. Roger Banzuela, Director of IYSPs. Brian Boyd B. Cordovilla, Head, Management Information System. Darlene May Mamhot, University Comptroller. Lucille E. Saguban, Generalist, Professional Resources Management Office. Micah Stefan B. Dagaerab, University Legal Officer and Data Privacy Officer. Maria Corazon S. Bernardes, General Consultant. Marichu G. Velasco, Head, Buildings and Grounds and Property Custodian. Juliet Quizon, Director, Creative and Multimedia. Alexi D. Miraflor, Director, Culture and the Arts. Jennifer Lozano Merecido, Head, Medical and Dental Services. Julius Perpetuo S. Heruela, Campus Minister. Jerry Lee M. Cordova, Head, Auxiliary Services. Glory May M. Tubog, Head, University Demo Farm.
Many of you have realized that it really is quite different these days. And I wouldn't be discouraged because the way we've structured things It's also a challenge for instructors. And our instructors have gone beyond the call of duty and have put together an informational structure, a learning structure, so that you can get more out of the situation than you've had in the past. So don't be discouraged. Keep up good thoughts. And remember, fuel your knowledge with Foundation University. And of course, don't forget, with the FUEL program, take advantage of this and be the one to make a difference.